Welcome to the Azure AD Architecture Deep Dive Series. I'm Michael Epping, and I'm a Program Manager on the Identity Engineering Division at Microsoft.
And hello, my name is Tariq Dawood, and I'm also a Program Manager in the Identity Division's Engineering Team.
We're part of the Customer Experience Team, and we help enterprises and businesses from all over the world to deploy our service and get to the cloud. We get a lot of questions about how Azure AD works under the hood, which we'll share with you throughout this architecture series. So Tariq, in our previous video, we discussed Azure AD regions and data centers. I heard there was also something called scale units. Can you tell us more about these and how they factor into how customer data is stored?
Let's dive in. So we, to summarize from the previous video in the series, we stopped at Azure Active Directory Core Store has regions, within the regions it has data centers, and data centers it has scale units and replicas. To understand how the scale unit system works, it's important to start with something called the directory access layer and the RBAC system on top of it.
So what happens when I try to read data from my tenant?
A great question. So the first thing to know that when any application or any service or any product or any user is trying to read or write data, including authenticate, to Azure Active Directory, ultimately they pass through the directory access layer, which is a layer that enforces basically isolation of multi-tenancy. It makes sure that tenant A is not trying to roam around the directory to read a tenant B's information, that user A is not trying to read stuff that they're not supposed to. This is enforced with the RBAC layer on top of it, which is a layer that no matter where the request is coming from, whether it's coming from internal Microsoft party or external, it makes sure that the person is authorized to do this. They have the right scopes and permissions to act on this data that they're trying to act on, whether it's read or write. And so this applies to, as I mentioned, internal interfaces. So Office 365 backend service, internal Windows service, or external interfaces. So your own applications calling the graph, calling the authentication endpoint. Ultimately, no matter where you're coming from, you're going to pass through this layer. And this layer, the first thing it does is it will try to locate where your data is stored.
So at this point, we need a way to actually find the appropriate tenant, correct?
Exactly. Because the tenants are not all stored in one big bucket, they're actually stored in separate containers and isolation units. The first thing we need is a lookup table. And so Azure Active Directory Core Store has a lookup table that contains pointers to where every tenant is stored. And so the directory access layer will go to the so let's say the request comes to the US data center, the blue data center one in the diagram here. And the data access layer tries to look up the tenant, the customer, and the lookup table will say that the customer, let's say, is stored in scale unit number 4. In this case, this data center does not have scale unit number 4. It's actually in the purple data center number 2. So this will allow the data access layer to redirect the request to another data center and say, go over there. And then when that data center uses the lookup table, it will find that the customer's data is in the scale units, hosted in this data center and hosted in this set of servers, and it will be able to serve the request.
And this helps us keep queries and lookups in the service speedy?
Absolutely. So now the ability to serve multiple customers at the same time and multiple requests across different customers is highly expedited by having this distributed design.
So what all goes into a scale unit? One tenant, a bunch of tenants?
Excellent question. The scale unit contains tons of tenants. So let's say tens of millions of objects can go into a scale unit. The scale unit that tries to serve all these objects, whether it's read or write queries or authentication traffic, as fast as it can. And we have monitors on each scale unit. Once the scale unit starts to get full, we stop adding new customers to it. So a customer will just create a new scale unit and new customers will go there. And we will let that scale unit grow organically. We also watch a scale unit if it starts to get full, even with the existing customers that are in it. Let's say they start adding more and more users, and we will start to load balance scale units. So we will move customers from a busy scale unit to a lighter scale unit so that they can all function, query, read, write as hard, as fast as they want to without affecting each other. So, Michael, did you know that there was a special kind of tenant that we haven't discussed in our previous slides.
I didn't. I'm curious, though, what's this special type of tenant?
That would be our B2C tenant. So Azure Active Directory has a CIAM solution, a consumer IAM solution called Azure Active Directory B2C, where we offer directory services for customers who are building very large consumer, large and small consumer facing applications such as loyalty, brand loyalty apps, retailing, purchase apps, and so forth. And the typical nature of these customers is that they have very large user bases. So a popular basketball, soccer, or football team may have 200 million user base, fan base. And so to allow all of them to come into Azure Active Directory, they may exceed the capacity of a single scale unit. And so rather than try to cram them all in, what we do with B2C customers specifically is that we shard them across multiple scale units. So a single B2C customer may have 50 million users in one scale unit, 20 million users in another scale unit, and so that they can continue to grow as much as they need without having to be limited by the architecture that we use.
It seems like a pretty clever design. Seems like a smart way to meet B2C customers' unique needs with the tried and true Azure AD system.
Exactly.
Thank you for that walkthrough on scale units, Tarek.
You're welcome, Michael. So to summarize what we discussed, scale units is basically how we grow our directory to serve millions of tenants and users and continue to grow without worrying about running out of memory or space. The data access layer and the role-based access controls involved in it is how we implement and enforce multi-tenancy and ensure that our customer data is only accessed by authorized entities. And then B2C customers and tenants have special scale requirements that cause them to span multiple scale units so that they can grow sometimes to hundreds of millions of users.
We hope you found this video useful. We'll be adding videos on different topics like authentication, provisioning, governance, and many more. If you want to get a copy of the diagrams we used today or want to give us feedback and help us figure out what to cover next, please follow the link on the screen.